I'm taking a look now at the LEGO pencil box and the package of pencils that you can get from the LEGO store in their stationery line right now. And the LEGO pencil box I've got has a red piece on it here, and it does come in different colours as well. I've seen it in blue, whereas the pencils, they only come in one colour or one style, but you do get two LEGO pieces here to attach to them. So let's open them and take a look. So you get 9 pencils in this packet, and they're all the same. Neither of them are sharpened at either end. You have to do that yourself. They've all got LEGO printed down the length of the pencil, and they're all graded the same, so they are all number 2 pencils. They look very nice, they feel very nice, but you know, a pencil is a pencil, and I guess you can do that good old magic trick where you make it look like it's bendy. But I guess what's cool about this is that you get these two little pieces here, which if I can't separate them, they're actually stuck on. But this one has the studs facing on top, and this one is basically the opposite way around. So you can actually connect them like this if you want to. And then when you put your pencils in it, but the idea is that you attach your pencil, or attach the end to your pencil. It slides on like that, and you do the same with this one. And then what you can do is to keep them together, I guess, you can push them together like that. So they're, it's kind of like chopsticks. But you can put them together like that, and that will stop them getting separated or lost in your bag or in your pencil case. But I guess the cooler thing you can do is actually attach stuff to it. So I'm going to attach the clapper board to this one, simply because I like it. So that looks pretty cool. Or with this one, broken my clapperboard. With this one, because the studs are facing outward, you can actually attach the minifigs to it like that. So it looks like that. That's pretty cool. I like that. This one is a little bit different because the studs are facing inwards, so you actually have the bottom of the plate here. But what LEGO recommends you do is actually have both of them on one pencil. So let's slide this up to the end, like this. It's quite tight. And then when you put this in your pencil case, you can attach it like that so that it won't move. Although it's obviously not going to fit in your pencil case with a minifig on it, but that's the idea of this. To be honest, I'm a little disappointed with this piece. It's a lot less useful than this one. And also, something else I don't like is that when you attach these clips and you slide them along, it actually damages the pencil slightly. It's left some marks in here, or some scratch marks as it's slid down. So that's quite disappointing as well. So that's the pencil set. They are nice. I think this would make a nice special gift for someone. I think a lot of people like to receive stationery or pencils as a present. So let's say you did have this. Well, you're going to need a pencil case to put them in. And fortunately, I picked up one of those too. So let's have a look at this. Okay, so here's the pencil case. And well, what can I say about it? It's a white box. Luckily for me, I like white. I like the minimalist look of it. And you may have noticed a theme with the LEGO sets, the LEGO stationery sets, is that they often have a brick piece on where you can attach stuff. And what you can do, seeing as we just looked at the pencils, is then attach a piece like this and then put your pencil on it. So then that will make it look kind of cool, and it will keep the pencil handy. Or if you move it down slightly, I guess what you could do is then put the minifigs on there, if I can get him on. Yep. Whoops, lost his piece. So you can decorate them like that. I think that looks quite nice. It's not really very practical though to have a pencil attached there, but you get the point. So like I said, you can get this in a different colour. I've seen it in blue. I quite like this red piece here. It's just a white box. I'll show you what these two holes are for. And you just pull it open. So let's see. Press that in. No? Okay. Okay. So you push that in. And then inside, again, it's just white. There's really not much going on in here at all. There is a green piece which slides around, and the holes are so you can push your fingers through to pop this green piece out. It just attaches via two clips here. So the idea, again, is that you can attach your LEGO accessories into the pencil case. So let's try and do that. So I've got the LEGO pencil again here. I've got the other piece which has the the studs facing away from you, so it's upside down, so you have the bottom piece facing you. And you can attach the pencil in there like that, and that will hold it in place quite nicely. It does look pretty nice, actually. And you can close the lid, and it's perfectly fine in there. It does rattle, but that's from the green piece rather than the actual pencil. So the pencil has stayed in place. You can also use your own pieces. So if you have a couple of these 1x2 bricks, what you can do is create a layout, something like this, where you line up the pieces. And then you can create a compartment or a separator using pieces of your own. So I can put another pencil in there if I wanted to, or a pen, and that would keep it separate from the rest of the pencil case. And you can actually fit two in there, that's quite cool. And there's room here for, I wonder if this will fit in. Okay, so that doesn't fit in there, but I guess you could fit a pencil sharpener, which I've got coming up in a later video. And will the ruler fit? And then the ruler fits in quite nicely as well. So let me remove that, because I don't think that's a good idea. So what I've done here is just taken a load of 1x2 clear pieces, which I have, and I've created a little compartment area, or a little section area, in which to put the ruler and the pencils. And I've put this piece here just to stop them shaking around, and again here. So you can have quite a lot of fun creating layouts for this. I think it is pretty cool. And I guess if you want to be able to get this ruler out easily, you're going to need a piece on there, maybe like that, so that you can just pull it like this. So let's see if we have that. Will it still close? And the answer is yes. It shakes around a bit more. That is pretty cool, actually. I like the idea. I like that you can attach stuff to the base plate and to the ruler, and you can even attach stuff here. If you've got some flat tiles or flat pieces, you can make it look a lot neater by adding those across the top, and the case will still be able to close. So yeah, I really like what they've done here. In fact, if I move these pencils to the other end, like this, and then I move these two out, you can probably get a minifigure in here. So let's get my Sigfig and place him in there. So he will fit in there. He won't sit fully back. There's a bit of a gap, and his arms will stay down. But even so, even with that, you can still close it and not have any problems. So I like this. I like what they've done there. Okay, so that wraps up my look at the pencil set and the pencil box. Overall, I think they'd make a nice gift. I think they're very expensive, but there is a lot of playability with these, and I really like that you can customize them by attaching bricks in different places and so on. So yeah, I think the range is good. I think it works very well together. If you're going to buy the whole lot, I think it will work out quite expensive. I paid about £50 for all of the LEGO stationery sets that I've bought. If you are thinking of buying this, as always, I recommend shopping around. Buying the stationery sets can work out to be quite expensive, so I've put some links in the bottom of the description below. Next up, I'm going to take a look at the eraser and the pencil sharpener that is in this range, and they fit nicely into this pencil case as well. So hit subscribe to stay up to date with more videos like this. Thanks a lot. Bye.